Design is form plus function. My name is Oliver Gerstheimer. Welcome to my HMI Design Masterclass. What is design actually? Designer nails, designer cars, designer furniture, design classics. Design has many aspects. The first is the result, aesthetics, beauty. The second is the design process, from draft to prototype, how the design results are created. Steve Jobs has defined design in these two sentences. Design is not just looks. It has three dimensions. How does it look? How does it feel? And how does it work for the user? Good HMI design creates added value. What does added value mean in design? Design either works or does not work. It's important for a common understanding to see design in its three dimensions of visual appearance, emotion, and finally, function, which defines the added value, saving time, avoiding errors, and happy users. We have to communicate and discuss this understanding when talking to colleagues, and stress that design is not just nice to have, but essential for improving the entire user experience. As human beings, we can identify quality very well. We recognize it easily, even if we cannot reproduce it. Sometimes, we also do not understand quality either. Take the example of food. We can easily tell a good dish from a bad one and identify quality. This capital Q for quality is essential in HMI design. And while being able to tell a good dish from a bad one will not make us automatically an expert cook, the real question is HMI design an art? Simple answer, no. It's not. It's a craft. And we can learn this craft step by step together. I am certain that we can sum up the essence of good design in 6x7 rules and principles that we will learn to use together. Six times seven principles. Read them once and you're all set. But it's not quite that simple. Rome wasn't built in a day, and we won't become design experts overnight. What we can do is learn step by step how to apply the key principles. Or to continue my analogy, in a cooking class, we will learn to work with temperature, ingredients, and spices, and slowly but surely become a better cook. We will use the principles of HMI design to create a good starting point for applying user-centric design elements to design an excellent user interface. Like any craft, HMI design involves a sequence of consecutive steps and processes. Quite a few blueprints for design processes have been developed over the past 100 years, using 3, 5, or 7 steps. What is important is not the number of steps, but their sequence. First trousers, then shoes. Now it's time to start the design process. And this process always begins with asking the right question. And the right question is, what are the actual tasks and targets? And you have to anticipate the solutions that will need to be created. Let's look at the core of design, which is the process of designing and discarding ideas. We will go through iterations, drafting a design and optimizing it, which often literally involves throwing away a sketch and starting with a clean sheet.
Das ist das Verwerfen.
Design involves three tasks: exploring solutions, refining your concept, and discarding ideas. Let's remember three things: analysis, concept, and most importantly, evaluation with the user. A chain is only as strong as its weakest link. But where is the weakest link in the complex interaction between a human user, an HMI, and a machine or plant? Is it the user? The machine? You need to optimize attention and focus. Maybe in the future we will see autonomous systems, voice control, new concepts. But today, the task at hand is designing user interfaces for real people that are a strong link in the chain and that match the machine's quality. A clear focus and user orientation are critical. But when you design a new HMI, you need also to be objective, and you need to systematically question whether what you have designed is really good. To be honest, quite a few HMI designers work from their own point of view and their own understanding of the user and the interaction instead of taking the user's point of view and truly thinking with a different mindset, which is essential for designing an HMI that is an integral part of the machine. And through it all, keep in mind that optimizing the HMI will improve the machine as well. Why do chairs typically have 3, 4, or 5 legs? If we were to design a chair, we would first take a look at other chairs, wouldn't we? Design originality is important, but not essential. So whenever we reach a point during the basic design, the initial questions, like we do here, where we ask ourselves what type of visualization should we use, how many elements should we use, we should take the easy way and just go on the internet. Get some inspiration from chairs, or in our case, HMIs, that others have designed. We can learn from good visualizations and representations that others have already designed. That doesn't mean that we just copy from others, but the inspiration will help optimize the process for our HMI design, especially in the time domain. With search engines, we can look for suitable images, and we can create our own interface collection. I did exactly that, and now we have a collection of options for our specific design issue. We can simply print out examples and physically pin them next to our basic concept. The HMI is not a mere detail, even though it often appears like this in many engineering schedules, where the HMI comes into the project late. This has to fundamentally change if we want to become user-centric and be a strong link in the chain. HMI design is a parallel process, and I'll add some elements that should be part of an optimum schedule. We should generate different insights for the HMI early in the project. But we should not have just one iteration phase at the end of the process, but integrate 3 to 4 review loops to gain more insights for our design alongside the general machine or plant engineering process. This is the core element and what makes our design user-centric: the dialogue and prototyping with an analysis phase here, a conceptual phase, and a prototyping phase, which will give us the insights to create a good HMI design that is a perfect match for the machine. To sum it all up, the HMI design process is a parallel process. And remember, the HMI is the face of the machine. And that's it for the first of our 7 units. You can find the 6 HMI design tips in the download PDF for this unit. Don't forget, the HMI is the face of your machine. Make sure it gets the attention it deserves. What? Still here? I didn't hear you. Next week, we'll take a deep dive into the world of context. Then it's your turn to listen really closely.